Na janma nu na mahato na sovagam na bang na buddhi na kritito shaheto toirijat brisistano pi na banu kasaha chakar sakshi batalakshanagraja.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, anybody coming in front of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, it was this excellent quality, excellent power of Prabhupada that he could realize in what condition he is. I mean, he could detect his condition. Anybody coming in front of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, it was a speciality of Prabhupada. Readily Prabhupada could understand that he is in this stage. So according to his quality, according to his stage, Prabhupada used to utilize him for this kind of special seva. It was a special duty of Prabhupada. Actually, point is that VarnAshrama Dharma, you know already, I told you, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told that Vimalapasa Saraswati is sent by Gauranga Mahaprabhu for this special purpose, to establish Daiva VarnAshrama Dharma. At the same time, to establish Siddhanta, special Siddhanta, Dham Parikram. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, for this special purpose, Vimalapasa Saraswati is sent by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu here in this material planet for this kind of special seva. Actually, today is the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Jivan Janadran Goswami Maharaj. Still, I like to discuss some point related to Daiva Varnasram. Ultimately, I can come to the conclusion of how Prabhupada used to apply this Varnasram Dharma, Daiva Varnasram Dharma actually. The sloka I started you, due to sickness, I forget every. Actually, point is that it is a sloka spoken by Hanumanji Maharaj. Na janma nu na mahato na sovagam na bag na bhutme. Actually, Hanumanji Maharaj speaking that Ramchandra, Lakshana Grojo, Ramchandra, love me, not because I am from a big family, not because I am from a big family, not because I am good looking, not because I have some any special quality, nothing. Actually, Ram Hanumanji Maharaj speaking that to enjoy the kripa of Supreme Lord, those factors not a big matter. From big family, like Kunti Devi, that day I told you, from a big family, he took birth, education, nice looking, all those are the not, you know, vital qualities for which he can get full kippa of Krishna, Supreme Lord. Kippa of, to enjoy kippa of Bhagavan Sri Krishna, he will have to show submission. Already I told you that Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, I am a beast actually. How I am getting full kippa of Ramchandra? I am doing seva. Krishna bhajane nahi jatkuladi vichar. Krishna bhajane nahi jatkuladi vichar. Who is doing bhajan? He can go up. That's not a big factor, in which family he is. So actually, Hanumanji Maharaj speaking this sloka, nice. And actually, you know, Jatayu also enjoying full kippa of Ramchandra Maharaj. You know, Savari, you heard the name of Savari. Actually, Sabaru is a Bhilnivai. Bhil, you know, who's staying in forest, those jati. Bhil, coal, bhil, tribals actually. He took birth there, Sabari. But still, by the mercy of Gurudev, Gautami Rishi, he enjoying full kripa of Ramchandra. You know the case. Sabari staying in ashram, those Munirishi staying there, they used to take bath in a pond, you know, nice sarovar there. Take bath there in sarovar, drinking water, everything. One day, they saw Sabari taking water from that pond. They become very angry. They chide him very heavily. She become frightened. She leave that place. After that, that pond become very dirty. From that day, the pond become very dirty. Very, very. Nobody can touch. Bad smell. Then those Rishi Munis, they thought it is because Sabari touching that sarovar. That's why it's contaminated, no more usable, we cannot use the sarovar. They thinking this way. But one day, very shortly, Ramchandra, Swayam coming there in that ashram, actually. And Ramchandra, Sabari waiting for long time. Gautami Rishi told her that Prabhu can come to give kipa to you. She is waiting for a long time. Every day collecting fruits and flowers, keeping in one place, and thinking that Ramchandra can come, I can offer. This way every day doing. Long time gone, but Ramchandra not coming. One day, Ramchandra coming to this ashram. Sabari, she was very happy. Then after that, Ramchandra, to show the exact, you know, mood of bhakti, Ramchandra speaking to Sabari, get some water from me, from that sarovar. But that sarovar is out of, you know, not usable, very bad quality at present. But still, Ramchandra speaking, you get some water from that sarovar. Sabari was bound to go there, get some water. As and when Sabari touching that sarovar, sarovar become very clean, like, you know, mirror. So then those Rishi Muni, they could realize that the condition of Sabari, though Sabari is from a low caste, very low caste, Vilnivai, still bhakti is totally different thing. Bhakti is totally different thing actually. So Sabari getting full kippa of Sri Ramchandra. This way actually, irrespective of caste and creed, we can prove bhakti is above all. Again, what Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, we like to go back to Purushottam Dham, there on Leela, actually. What Leela? Actually, Sarvam Bhattacharya and wife mean Shatir Ma, used to cook for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Every day, almost every day, when they invite, then one day, Sarvam Bhattacharya invite Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and taking prasadam inside room. But son-in-law want to watch the room inside. But Sarvam Bhattacharya knowing that he has no right to watch. That's why always speaking, don't enter room. But that day, by chance, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was served prasadam, That time he was ready to take prasadam, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time, that son-in-law of Sarvam Bhattacharya suddenly watched that Mahaprabhu taking lot of prasadam and started criticizing. And sannyasi, so huge amount of prasadam taking, this way criticizing. So when criticizing, then Sarvam Bhattacharya could notice, then, you know, run after him. He is running and Sarvam Bhattacharya running after him. After that he gone, Sarvam Bhattacharya coming in front of Mahaprabhu and speaking, I invite you to insult. I invite you here to insult. He is useless. And that's why he insult you. And what to do? Then after that, Sarvam Bhattacharya and Shatirma, I mean, wife of Sarvam Bhattacharya, fasting for 1 or 2 days. For 1 or 2 days, Sarvam Bhattacharya and wife fasting, Mahaprabhu, never mind, Mahaprabhu saying what to speak is actually not aged man, he is small, young age, maybe he is speaking this way. We should not, think that way. Then after that, Mahaprabhu gone, when he started cholera. Who? That son-in-law of Sarvam Bhattacharya developed cholera. He is almost dying, almost going to die. Then after that, what happens? Then Sarvam Bhattacharya speaking is right, very good. He is dying very good. But when Sarvam Bhattacharya was, speaking this way, Mahaprabhu speaking, you should forgive him, no problem. When almost dying, then he meet Mahaprabhu. Then Mahaprabhu speaking in front of him, actually your body is Brahman body. Your body is actually Brahman body. Brahman body is for Hari Bhajan. Why you are thinking that way? Mastajya chandal kene iha vasaila, pavitra stan kene apavitra koila. Prabhu kahe, Prabhu speaking, your body is Brahman body. Krishner vasati e yogya sthal hai. Brahman body, your body is Brahman body. Krishna can sit inside Brahman body very, very nicely. Why you are contaminating this place? Why you are making rubbish? So Krishner vasati ei yogya sthal hoy mascharjo chandal kene iha vasaila pavitra sthan kene apavitra koila. Your heart should be very pure. Why you are making dirty here, contamination? So Prabhu cannot sit here, Supreme Lord cannot sit here. This way Mahaprabhu identified a Brahman body. Brahman body means with Brahman bhav. Brahman means he should have seva mood, he should have strong belief in Supreme Lord. After that he should not have any jealousy, any envious attitude, nothing. This way actually Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, any man coming, any type of man coming in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu used to bless them proper way. Mahaprabhu used to bless them proper way, engage them rightly. Prabhupada also used to engage those devotees accordingly. Prabhupada also used to engage them accordingly. This was the special quality of Prabhupada. If body is Brahman, it's not possible. If only this material body is Brahman, it is not possible because it is made of panchabhut, five elements, everybody, all elements, beast and birds, everybody, these five elements. So this body is made of five elements. we cannot speak this body is actually Brahman. If caste is Brahman, caste, it is not possible. Because just now I told Hanuman took bath, where Jatayu took bath, Gajendra took bath actually, Vrittasur took bath, where? After that, Vasishtha Muni took birth from Urvashi. Vasishtha Muni took birth from Urvashi. And after that, Rishyasringa Muni from deer. Rishyasringa Muni from deer. After that, Agastya Muni from pitcher. Dronacharya from the pot where you put arrow. Arrow, you know? From that pot, Dronacharya took birth. This way, actually, we cannot say that caste is any kind of caste is not Brahman. So, in which family he has taken, but not a big factor. The Brahman is a special quality, special bhava. If he is not having, then we cannot speak that he is Brahman. We cannot speak. So this way, actually, we can see Rishabdev. Rishabdev actually is the avatar, Bhagavat avatar, Rishabdev. But he is 100 sons. Out of that, 81 sons become pure Brahman. 81 sons. After that, you can say, Nava-yugandra, they become Nava-yugandra. Nava-yugandra, they become. This way you can see, actually, Brahman is not caste, Brahman is not body, Brahman is not material mind, nothing. Brahman is one bhav, special bhav. And in Gita, you can find one special thing.
Sriyanu sadharmo vigunaha paradharmat sanusthitat sadharme nidhanam shreyo paradharma bhayavaha.
Sadharme nidhanam shreyo paradharma bhayavaha. Sadharme nidhanam shreyo paradharma bhayavaha. According to their quality, according to their previous sanskar, according to their previous sanskar, if they are developing this kind of condition, according to that we will have to judge. According to that we will have to judge. Not like blind. Actually, according to their previous sanskar, they are exhibiting at present what quality they are exhibiting, what state. According to that, you will have to pass judgment. So previously, those Rishi Munis, they used to apply this principle and identify he is Brahman, maybe from Kshatriya family. He has taken birth in Kshatriya family. Still, Rishi Muni used to speak is Brahman. And also from Brahmin family he took birth. Also, we see sometime, we identify his Kshatriya. Jamadagni Muni, his son. Jamadagni's son? Who? Parshuram. Parshuram actually he took birth in Brahmin family, but exhibiting Kshatriya quality. Actually, showing Kshatriya quality. So, it depends. According to their previous sanskar, what stage they have, they are going to show, according to that you will have to identify varna and ashram, otherwise not. Actually, see, today is the disappearance day of Janadran Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Jivan Janadran Goswami Maharaj. He took birth in Rai Ramananda family. He took birth in Rai Ramananda family, and actually seven or eight successions, I cannot remember. He took birth in Rai Ramananda family, successor board, I say, he came from Ganjam district, one place in almost Orissa and Andhra border, Ganjam district, where Srila Vaikhanas Gosai Maharaj took part. Vaikhanas, you know, Bhakti Gaurav, Vaikhanas Gosai Maharaj took part there. Actually, Raj Pandit, he was Raj Pandit. He took birth there, almost there, Ganjam district, there. From there he came, actually. He met Prabhupada and took shelter of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. And after that, he used to stay there in sometime in Chaitanya Mad, sometime in Orissa, some temple in Orissa, Chatak Parbat, so many places actually. It's very, very nice quality. He exhibiting very nice quality. Actually, point is that he was Puran Bhakta. Puran, you know, all Puran he memorized. He was Puran Bhakta. He used to speak Puran very nicely. Siddhanta. He is making temple in Kharagpur, two temples you can find. In Kharagpur, he is making two temples. One Golbajar, one place from Kharagpur station near, another inside. I went there long ago, one time. Two temples he is making there. As actually, he developed friendship, very strong friendship with Bhaman Gosai Maharaj. Because Bhaman Gosai Maharaj, from almost childhood, used to stay with Prabhupada, I mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That time, Bhakti Janadran Gosai Maharaj also used to stay there in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From then, they developed friendship, very nice friendship. And they are actually, Janadran Gosai Maharaj used to do different seva, like cultivation seva, this, that, so many seva. And he developed friendship with Bhaman Gosai Maharaj. They used to serve Guru Vaishnava all the time, continuously. All senior Vaishnava, they used to serve them very nicely all the time, and very humble mood, very humble mood. Actually, Janadran Gosai Maharaj, making mod there, have some special quality. I heard from Bhaman Gosai Maharaj that Janadran Gosai Maharaj, inside Gopi Bhav, externally is actually staying this way, but internally is Gopi Bhav. One day Bhaman Gosai Maharaj saying that he used to act as a Gopi. Just inside Gopi, outside, like ordinary man. And all cows, you know, he used to keep cows there, cows in his temple, so many cows. He used to love cows. He is sometimes passing remark, we are actually coward. So we have a special love for Gomata. Always used to serve Gomata. Always used to serve Gomata. At the same time, when going outside, sometime going outside for 2-5 days, when coming back, then coming with some special, you know, fruits and everything for Gomata, banana, everything. Gomata, they are so clever, they could realize that Maharaj coming by smell. When Maharaj entered temple, the Gomata, they used to, you know, shout. They know Maharaj coming. Then Maharaj first enter Gaushala, giving, you know, banana, fruits, everything to Gomata. After that, he used to enter his own room. Otherwise not. So punctual actually. And one day, he giving order for Prabhupada's deity in Jaipur, you know. In Jaipur, Janadran Maharaj giving order, one, you know, Vigraha of Prabhupad, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur. So after that Vigraha coming to his temple. Somebody going there. After that, in he be packing, you know, he be packing. That Vigraha coming in heavy packing. And after that, when Vigraha was, you know, unloaded from car, then Janadran was shouting, open the packet very quickly. Then after that, then those devotees, they open the pack very quickly and put the Vigraha there in veranda, in some pure place. Then Janardhan Maharaj started doing arati. Janardhan Maharaj started doing arati. Everybody surprised, what happens? The deity need installment. We need to install the deity first. After that, we can do arati. By Janardhan Maharaj readily speaking, hey, bring arati, quickly. Started arati. This way, they started arati. But everybody, they couldn't realize what happens. Then Janardhan Maharaj saying, actually, if Vigraha is saprakas, you know, self-manifested. If Vigraha already manifest in my heart, I simply give order to that sculpture. Actually, Vigraha already manifest into my heart. I give simply order outside. Vigraha coming, mean Vigraha, I can worship, start it. Same thing happened when Prabhupada went to SM. Prabhupada went to SM. Rayanamananda Prabhu means our that Siddhar Goswami Maharaj. Siddhar Goswami Maharaj went there in Assam, first mot, Gaudiya mot opening. Prabhupada went there and Vigraha was there, everything ready, temple going to be inaugurated, Vigraha installment ceremony, Prabhupada already there in Bhajan Kutir. And Prabhupada giving instruction to Raya Ramananda Prabhu, you go and prepare everything. If everything ready, then you can call me. I can come and start ceremony. Then actually Raya Ramananda Brahmachari, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj arrange everything. Deity cleaning everything. First cleaning. After that, singar, cloth, everything done. Everything, all arrangement, dove inside. After that, putting some garland there to Vigraha. After that, calling Prabhupada. Prabhupada, everything ready. Could you come now? Then everything ready. Prabhupada coming there. Open the screen and become surprised. Vigraha already installed. I need not install. Everybody surprised. How possible? Installment ceremony not taken as yet, not taken place. Baba speaking, because Rai Ramananda giving garland to that Vigraha and pran, I mean, Vigraha, in Vigraha, Krishna and Radharani already come, Gaurani already come. This way I also heard from Guru Maharaj, those who are Siddha Mahatma, those who are elevated soul, they are great super personality. If they are giving order, then in Jaipur or anywhere for Vigraha, when Vigraha coming, actually by their love, pran, actually life coming inside Vigraha. And Ramanujacharya also speaking that you cannot pay dandavat to any Vigraha. Which is any Vigraha. All Vigraha you cannot pay dandavat. Any Vigraha installed by pure Guru Vaishnav, you can pay dandavat. Outside people making looks like idol. like you cannot. Ramanuja just speaking. If any deity, any Shivji Maharaj installed by any pure Brahman Vaishnava, in that case you can pay dandava. If actually for some reason Vigraha gone, Vigraha is there, but life gone from Vigraha. Suppose in any temple there is some babichar. Babichar means excesses going on. They are not following any rules and regulations, nothing. Vyabhichar, doing all rubbish. In that case, deity, I mean life can go away from that deity. Follow? Life can go away from deity. Deity is there, externally. But deity, from deity, life can go away. Again, one pure Vaishnava, if any deity, there is no life, not installed. If any pure Vaishnava paying dandavad, pure Vaishnava paying dandavad, instant Krishna can come there. This way actually, Janadran Maharaj wanted to prove that any pure devotee, giving order, then if Vigraha coming, then automatically there is pran, life is there. But still, for the teachings of common men, they arrange installments, Vigraha installment ceremony, this, that they do. This way they are doing actually. Janadran Maharaj asking to Bhaman Goswami Maharaj when he was aged. Almost 68, 70, where I can make my samadhi? Where? Then Maman Goswami identified this place is proper. From here you can see Vigraha properly. That there actually, they make samadhi actually, today, this day actually, samadhi dan. And Maman Goswami Maharaj are there in South India. When Janadran Maharaj leaving his body, that time Bhaman Goswami Maharaj was there in South India, some place. Some devotee giving information to Bhaman Goswami, Gurudev, just now we get information that Janadran Goswami Maharaj leaving his body. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj speaking, I know already. After leaving body, he come here, meet me, and then going. He already told. This way actually, Janadran Goswami Maharaj actually used to stay there, no, making disciple there, at present they are maintaining temple. Condition not good actually, anyway, they are doing. So today I like to stop because of sickness. I like to stop here if you have any question. And that day actually, I forget to speak you that day. When I go down there, then I could remember the second slok. Same sequence happened. It was written by Muraregupta. You know Muraregupta? Muraregupta wrote Muraregupta Karcha. Actually, all whole Chaitanya Leela we can get from Muraregupta Karcha and from Sarup Gosai Karcha. Sarup Gosai Karcha, Raghunath Das Goswami memorize and write something in Gambhira Mandir, and Muraregupta from the very beginning, Muraregupta knowing everything here. Same thing happened here in Jagannath Mishra's house. That is same thing, same almost same sloka. Actually, I forget, maybe 16, 18 years back, actually this happened there. In Gambhira Mandir. Because think, when I go down, I can remember the second sloka. Darotrayam anudghatto bhittitrayam uru bilanga uchai kalingi kosurovi madhyapatita. This sloka. When I remember, I could say, I forget actually. Due to see so many pressure there, labor working, 10, 12 labor there, whole day, actually. Goshala there. Actually, due to that, Anyway, if you have any question, I can, because today I cannot speak in details due to sickness. I like to stop.
Maharaj, last time that you were speaking, you were talking about how Diksha changes a person from his previous material body, like a gold, a bell metal station.
Provided his inclination is perfect. Inclination.
So I would like to understand the difference between Harinam, because from Harinam we also get the same result. So how to harmonize what we get from Harinam and what we get from Diksha?
Actually, this already given, Bhaktivinoda Thakur already gave answer. I published one book already 7-8 years back, Bengali actually. Point is that Dikha Purascharan Vidhi Apekshana Kare. Dikha Purascharan Vidhi Apekshana Kare. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one sensitive issue. One sensitive issue written in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Dikha Purascharan Vidhi Apekshana Kare. Jivha Sparse Achandale Udhare. Maybe Chandal and come from low family, low caste, low family. No matter. Irrespective of caste and case, Harinam can deliver you. No need of Diksha and nothing. Now, your question is very nice question. Everybody can get nice information today. Point is that Diksha 100% necessary. Without Diksha, I cannot go. And actually, Harinam itself complete. How to harmonize? Harinam itself complete. Harinam itself complete. Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving answer. There, Raghunath Das Gosai already writing Samantreshi Namni, you know. Already writing that you need Diksha. Why? Because for infinity period, you have some connection with this material world. For infinity period, you have some connection with this material world. Like one tree, you see, after 500 years, one banyan tree or a branch is going down. 5,000, 5,000. Two, I have seen one banyan tree 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 years back. 5,000 banyan tree. Where branches you cannot find a seed, where is the actual root. So those material people staying here in this material world, they have some affinity in this material world. I mean attachment. That is like tree. Follow what I say. Like tree, having some branches inside. See, if you like to, you know, impossible. This way, bonded souls, for infinity period, they have material connection. It is quite impossible for them to cut this material bondage. I already told you, I can explain next day. Very nasty. Today's sloka also due to sickness. Evam guru pasanaika bhaktya vidya kutarena sitena jira vibrischa jiva sayamayam apramatya sangbrischa atmanamatho. I told you, tejahastam. This sloka. So, by the hacksaw, you have to cut. How? Guru Kipa. Guru Kipa, first you can get Harinam, then Diksha. Diksha is a must. Diksha can cut your material bondage, Gayatri. First you get Gayatri. That Gayatri mantra job can help you to cut this material bondage. You go on doing Gayatri mantra, Brahma Gayatri. Material attachment can go away, can go. Because Krishna is standing on such a excellent platform which is impossible for ordinary people to reach. Because Rupa Goswami Padore, Rupa Goswami what told? Mukta kulei rupasamanam. Mukta kulei rupasamanam. Harinam sansar. Rupa Goswami Pad writing. Krishna is only can be worshipped by a mukta purush, who is totally free of material. Material attachment is there, at the same time you are doing bhajan, not possible. So what about how we can harmonize? Yeah, at the same time you are speaking Harinam itself complete, and again you are speaking Diksha is 100% necessary. Yeah? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, according to your previous sanskar, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, according to your previous sanskar, if you are having 100% belief in Krishna Nam, follow my point. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, according to a previous sanskar, maybe previous life you are doing bhajan, maybe, who can say? So you are having strong affinity from Krishna Nam, Harinam. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, for them, no need of Diksha. Harinam itself can deliver you. Externally you can find Parikshit Maharaj not taking any Diksha from anybody. Externally you can find Parikshit Maharaj not taking Diksha from anybody. Parikshit Maharaj only hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. Okay, fine. And Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, je Bhagavat, listening Bhagavat from top to bottom, whole. Janmadasya yato, nama sankirtanam yasso, sarvabha, total. After hearing, somebody asking, je how we can say Parikshit Maharaj is initiated? Prabhupada asking, that what do you mean by Diksha? Prabhupada asking, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami, what do you mean by Diksha? Diksha means to develop sense of knowledge, relationship, avidya, sambandha avidya prayajan. Follow? Prabhupada speaking this way, giving argument. Bhagavad Katha he is hearing. After hearing total Bhagavad Katha, actually Parikshit Maharaj developing all three, sambandha avidya prayajan. So how you can say that actually is not getting an initiation? Because Janmadasya Jato, this slok is Brahma Gayatri, always Gayatri. Gayatri na? Dhe, is also Gayatri. So Parikshit Maharaj already initiated, only by Bhagavad Katha. His sanskar was so nice. And at the same time in Bhagavad, it is in Mahabhagavata, Esho Mahabhagavata, 3-4 times. I can show you after. So actually Parikshit Maharaj initiated by Bhagavad Katha, listening Bhagavad Katha. When hearing Bhagavad Katha, his Diksha is done. He is a disciple of Sukadev Goswami. He cannot say he is not initiated. At the same time, if some ordinary, if common people, if they are initiated, still after 20 years gone, they are never not developing any sense of relationship, Shambandha Gyan, then how you can say he is initiated? Not possible. So, initiation, Prabhupada explaining two ways. One is so-called initiation, one is actual, another is actual initiation. Actual initiation means your Shambandha Gyan pakka. Because without Shambandha Gyan, you cannot start avidya. Prabhupada speaking, without Shambandha Gyan, you cannot start avidya. First, Sambandha Gyan should be there, then the question of avidya coming. Otherwise, no avidya. Who can? In material world, we can find one girl when going to marry, after that, some material relation grow up, she can understand, he is my husband. After that, one baby take birth, hey, my baby. Then automatically duty coming. Duty, inspiration, I mean duty coming when relationship coming. I mean sense of relationship. In material world we can find those mother, father, friends and foe, they are doing everything according to their sense of relation. Relationship they grow. They are getting some material duty, they are doing everything. So, whereas in material ground, material world, we can find they are getting inspiration to do some duty. Similarly, you have your eternal duty for Krishna, but until and unless you develop Sambandha Gyan, you cannot start over there. So, Sambandha first be there. If you are Diksha, by Diksha, if you are not developing Sambandha Gyan, no question of Abhidya. After Sambandha Gyan, strong Sambandha Gyan, you can start Abhidya. After Abhidya, you can get the final goal, Prayajan. Abhidya is perfect, then you can get Prayajan. Then Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, by Harinam can help you. Harinam can help you, provided you have, Harinam can help you 100%. If you have 100% belief in Harinam, the Harinam is complete, Hari is equal to Harinam, if you have 100% belief, then you need not take any Diksha. By Harinam, your Diksha can be completed. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, if you have, according to your previous sanskar, if you are 100% believing Harinam, I get Harinam mean everything is done. Then by Harinam, you can come out successful. Otherwise, you will have to take Harinam, and to get actual Harinam, you will have to take Diksha also, Gayatri, to cut material bondage. Then gradually you will have to transcend the material bondage and go up, cut material bondage and go up. This way, Diksha and Harinam both actually essential. But if you have 100% belief in Harinam, then you need not take Diksha. It's complete. That's why you will have to take. Usually it is not seen. Usually everybody doing Harinam, they cannot believe 100% that Harinam is Hari. The moment you realize, that means you are meeting Krishna, Hari. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking, to take Harinam and to meet with Krishna, same thing. To take Harinam and to meet with Krishna is all same thing. So this way actually you will have to think. So Diksha is 100% necessary. Because common people, they don't have that much quality. That's why after Harinam, you will have to wait, but because Guru Varga first give Harinam. But anyway, Harinam, if there is any propensity to do any, pap, sinful activity, anyway, not purposely, unknowingly. Purposely, if you do, it is Namaparad. This purposely, not is somehow doing. This way, they can cut and go up, practice. After that, Gurudev giving Diksha. Sometime Gurudev giving Diksha, Harinam at a time. Harinam and Diksha at a time. Sometime it happens. It depends in what condition he is present. This way actually.
Another question, Maharaj. You are also speaking about two types of guru. You are quoting this verse, Kiva Vipra Kiva Narasi Shuddhiki Nanasi. As someone who knows Krishna, he is guru. But you are also saying the guru means he's resident of Goloka. So how to harmonize these two?
What? First question you speak again, I cannot hear.
On one side you're saying, Guru means, Kiva Viprakima Nyarasi Shuddhiki Nanayi Krishna Tattva Vetas.
Yes.
So this is it seems a general understanding of Guru, but you gave very specific understanding also, saying Guru means, he's resident of Goloka.
Yes.
So how to harmonize the two?
Actually, Kiva Shudra Kiva Nashi, Vipra Kiva Shudra Kiva Nasi Kiva Vipra Kiva Nasi Shudra Kane Noi. Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sei Guru Hai. Actually, I can give you example one by one. Raya Ramanando taking birth in Shudra family. I can give answer. Bhangshidas Babaji Maharaj taking birth in fisherman family. Gaurkishat Das Babaji Maharaj taking birth in Vaishya family. Raghunath Das Goswami Maharaj taking birth in Vaishya family. Most of our Guru Varga, they are taking birth in Vaishya family. Not that all of them coming from Brahman family. So actually, those who are having eternal relation with Prabhupada, eternal relation, Goloka, they have their eternal residence in Goloka, that means how you can realize. Actually, point is that Sri Chaitanya Manavishto Sthapitam Jena Bhutale. If this point is satisfied, then you can understand his eternal residence of Goloka. Follow? Scientific evidence. If you can understand, that Sri Chaitanya Manavishto Sthapitam Jena Bhutale. Like one incident I can say, Bhagavati Ma, I mean, wife of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I mean the mother of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, material relation. Actually, we are now speaking father, mother, this relation we never speak. But anyway, I hope to speak. One day, from Calcutta, came here to take darshan of Gaurkishadad Bhaji Maharaj. They came and paying dandavat to Gaurkishadad Bhaji Maharaj. Gaurkishadad Bhaji Maharaj in joking mood. Asking, Ma, Mother, what for you are coming here? To take darshan of Vigraha or for marketing, special marketing in Navadvip? What for you have come? Actually, I have come here to take your darshan. My darshan? You cannot understand that your Gaur Parshad is there inside your room, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Why you waste your time to come here? Speaking this way. You are coming here for special marketing or for, Vigraha Darshan? Why you have come here? I have come to take your darshan. Why you are wasting your time? Already Gaur Parshad there inside your room, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Nobody knows. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur there inside room. Actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is eternal Parshad. Why? Bhaktivinoda Thakur getting order from Tarakeshwar, one Swadasip there. In Hugli, one Mahadev, Bhaktivinoda Thakur went there someday for some official job. And night time sleeping, a Mahadev came in front of him. Hey, why you took decision to go to Vrindavan? Why? You don't know this Gupta Vrindavan there, Navadip Dham? Who can take responsibility? Because Prabhupada speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is Nodiya Prakash. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is expressing the glories of Gauranga, the eternal person. Sri Chaitanya Manavishto Sthapitajnana. I can give another example, one by one. Bhaktisiddhanta Babaji Maharaj doing Bhajan there. Excellent. If you go on hearing or this Leela, can go mad. They are all eternal person. How you can understand? Because they all wanted to establish Bhajan mode, how to do Bhajan, how to go ahead, how to preach. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Bhumatpuri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Swami Maharaj, they all coming. Maybe they are from Vaishya family, from some of them from Brahman family, some of them from Khotriya family even. What to do? This way actually, Raya Ramananda taking birth in a low family. And actually Kala Krishnadas, you know, Kala Krishnadas, yes. Mahaprabhu leave him. Mahaprabhu gone to South India, you know the case. Kala Krishnadas. With Mahaprabhu going to South India. Bhattatari. Then after fall down, then Mahaprabhu catch and come here. Nityananda Balaram is so merciful. I can explain this point someday. That when Gauranga Mahaprabhu don't like to give mercy, Nityananda ready. Regarding Jagai Madhe, you already know. Kala Krishna, take the case of Kala Krishna. When Mahaprabhu already reject, go away, I don't know. What you can do? Then Nityananda is so merciful. Nityananda take him, give some consolation, giving some seva, with some article and prasadam sending, giving some seva, sending him to Navadvip. So Baldev Charitra, Guru Charitra, so special, it's very special. Like Duryodhan, so wicked, so, you know, dangerous. Feed Balaji Maharaj, Krishna never liked, but Balaji Maharaj always like. It's a speciality, but you cannot understand. So much fallen, but still Balaji Maharaj like to help him. This way actually, so Kiva Sudra, Kiva Vipra Kiva Nashi, Sudra Kane Noi, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta Sai Guru Hai. So when is Tattva Vetta? Tattva Vetta mean? Tattva Vetta mean? He is knowing Tattva. And Tattva he can realize Tattva. Tattva-vitta means not he is memorizing Tattva. Tattva-vitta means? Tattva-vitta means realizing Tattva. Realizing Tattva means his condition is so high. He is doing seva, eternal seva. So, what wrong in it? No problem. Maybe he is from Sudra. From low caste, what happens? So, what problem? No problem. He can act as guru. He is actually, he can act as guru. No problem. Even some Mataji is also acting as guru. Janna Mata Thakurani. And a daughter of Srinivasa Acharya, Hemlata Thakurani. Acting as guru. But not everybody. Everybody cannot do. It depends. On those ancient days, Rishi Munis, you can find some Gayatri. They used to get Brahma Gayatri. Brahma Gayatri. They. What name? Gayatri, Dapare, forget. Everything I know, sometimes I forget. Everything I know, I forget sometimes. Maitri, Gargi, they used to get skirted to Inga. But for that, ordinary people, ordinary Matajis, they cannot do. Speciality. They are beyond any Sri Dharma. You know Sri Dharma? They are beyond Sri Dharma. Shyam, we can find Rishi, they are actually women. In Veda, you can find some Rishi, they are women. Some mantra came in front of them. They watch and write. Previous day. So it's a special case.
People tend to take this verse very lightly, though, Maharaj.
Huh?
They take this verse in a very light way. But yes, I know Krishna, so I can be Guru.
No, actually, Jai Krishna Tattva Vetta, Shai Guru Hoy, he can act as Guru. No problem. What problem in it?
Because I'll speak specifically in my experience with this kind. Half of my God brothers took the post of Guru. All left Krishna consciousness and fell down in very shameful ways.
No, actually, this is a case different. I told you one question. Eternal Guruji, Guru, eternal existence there, that means Sri Chaitanya Manavishto Sthapitam Jnana Murutale. It should be perfect. Like one verse you can find about Prabhupad when we Sujanar Budharadito Paduju. There you can find? There you can find one soul. Paramhansa Param Paramarthapadim Potitodharanekrita Veshajitin. He took sannyas to deliver all fallen souls. But now I have seen many acharya, many sannyasis they are speaking. He took Harinam from Prabhupada. He is the eternal person of Prabhupada. It is not possible. Not that all and everybody took Harinam and Diksha from Prabhupada. Not that all of them are person. Follow me.
Yes.
Not that they are all of them person. But they want to prove they are all eternal person. No? Otherwise this verse, Patitodharanekritavishti. He took sannyas. He is acting as acharya to deliver common mass. He is useless. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivering common, you know, bonded soul also, and also, you know, some eternal person of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu coming around him. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu moving here and there, not that everybody eternal person. Everybody eternal person. No. They meet Chaitanya Mahaprabhu maybe, have some relation, not that all of them eternal person. Can you prove? No. You go through je Gaur Ganadesh Deepika. You can find so many personalities, nice personality. But Gaur Ganadesh Deepika, you cannot find their identity. They are no eternal person. Nothing, no name there. So not that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu meeting anybody, they are eternal person, not that. So, Prabhupada came here in this material planet to deliver all common people. Not that all of them came in front of Prabhupada, took Harinam and Diksha, or eternal person, not that. Follow? So, some of them can maybe, they are forcefully acting as Acharya, fall down. This case is different. By eternal existence, they fall down, it's impossible. How possible? Intellectual, his mood is totally different. To understand a pure Vaishnava, you will have to stay with him, watch. Whole day and night what he is doing. Then you can understand. If you can memorize some tattva, if you are going for preaching, not that you are establishing, you know, Chaitanya Manavishya Sthapitang Vedh. For preaching, you need some special quality. Already written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Prabhupada many times speaking, many times, sometime in Bengali Sanskrit writing. There it is written, there, without the kippa of Krishna, Krishna Shakti Bina Nahe Bhakti Pavartan. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, be careful, you can misunderstand that everybody going here and there preaching. Here and there, they are all eternal, not there. They can misunderstand me. So you are very intelligent, you should understand what I mean to say. I cannot go in detail, I have no mood to fight with anybody.
I don't bring it up to yes. Find fault with anyone.
Yes, it is written, Krishna Shakti Bina Nahe Bhakti Pavartan. Bhakti Pavartan means, if you can see one Vaishnava coming in front of you are feeling some bhakti. Bhakti Mataji even speaking this way, if you are coming in front of any Vaishnava, he is not speaking anything, only sitting. If just watch, you can get some power. Bhakti Mataji. So this kind of influence you cannot find everywhere. So actually, to preach means to install bhakti inside a bonded soul. It is not possible. It is possible for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to install bhakti inside animal also. That day I told, it was possible for Rasikananda Prabhu to install bhakti inside elephant. It was possible for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to install bhakti inside tiger and they are dancing with Harinam. It is not possible for everybody. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving instruction to their what name? Kushti Vipra after he get nice body, reback his nice body, and also another Vipra, Vasudev Vipra, Mahaprabhu speaking, go and preach. Their special case, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu giving some special power to them, it is written, anybody meeting them, they are getting bhakti. That was a special case. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here in this material planet, that was a special case. That was a special case, even Chaitanya used to give everybody. Patra, patro, vicharanam, na kurute, na sa parang bhikshate, deya deova mimarsaka, na hish, na va, kalo, pratiksha, prabhu. It is written, it is special case when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came here in this material planet. That is a special case. Anybody coming in front of Mahaprabhu, if there is no aparad, nothing, obvious to go. Even aparad, if aparad gone, in his lifetime, a lila time, like, you know, this Devananda Pandit,
Devananda Buddha doing big aparad. He is reciting Bhagavatam. See, Srinivasa Acharya ji is crying. His disciple putting outside. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Antaryami become very angry. But after that, he got the scope to serve Bhakkeshwar Pandit. Bhakkeshwar Pandit here. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu become very happy. Why Keshav Goswami Maharaj giving this name, Devananda Gaudiya Math? Why? As a speciality. To give you a reminder, be careful about Devananda Pandit. Don't try to become a dry Pandit. Devananda Pandit. That's why Keshav Goswami Maharaj name this, Devananda Gaudiya Math. So that if you can say Devananda Gaudiya, you can remember, oh, Devananda Pandit done this. Knowing Bhagavatam is all you can recite, but no bhakti. No bhakti. Even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu want to take, snatch Bhagavat from him. He has no right to read Bhagavatam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking. Whereas all public can say he is a big Pandit. Follow? This way, if you judge, you can find that actually what I wanted to speak? Devananda Pandit, he was actually Pandit, but not actual Pandit. Aap make aparad. Aparad was vanished. So in lifetime, Leela time, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to give kippa to everybody. Chapal Gopal also. Chapal Gopal approach Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu said, it is nothing. You will have to suffer birth after birth. I cannot give you. After that, when beg for pardon, chapal goes. This way it was, even Kaji, you know, Muslim Kaji. Chand Kaji. Chand Kaji also. Getting the kippa from Mahaprabhu this way, but not always. That's why you see somebody speaking, Nabhajityo Dai Prem Dhan. Somebody mix explaining there. In Vrindavan, here, there. Without Bhajan, Mahaprabhu can give you everything. Speaking in front of public. The, if it is, you know, Nabhajito without Bhajan, how possible? Why Mahaprabhu speaking, Shaddha Vastu Sadhan Vina Keho Nahi Pai? Without Sadhan, Shaddha Vastu, target you cannot get. Mahaprabhu speaking. Narottama Thakur writing in his Kirtan, Sadhan Saran Lila Tahatena Karo Hela Kaya Mane Koriya Sushar Bengali. You can go through Prem Bhakti Chandrika and Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandrika. You can go, it is written. Sadhan Saran Lila. Your Sadhan and Saran under the guidance of Sadguru. Go on doing. Don't express any kind of audacity. Don't do aparad. Sadhan Saran Lila Tahatena Karo Hela Kaya Mane Koriya Sushar. Kaya Mane body, mind and speech. You have to harmonize. Sushar means Bengali word. You have to harmonize. Follow. Guru Bhagavatam heart is so heavy. External, outside people cannot understand. The mood of pure Vaishnava. They cannot understand. So actually, without bhajan, you cannot get. So sometimes you can find so many people going, they can pass lecture nicely, going to foreign country. I am not going to criticize them. I beg for pardon. They are going. Sometimes they fall down. So special quality, Prabhupada giving, and in Chaitanya Charitamrita also, if time permits, if I, my health is good, I can go on speaking very deep discussion. Actually, it is written, Akarat opi bhedabhyam, srinam vishayanam opi. Akarat opi bhedabhyam, this sloka is spoken by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Akarat opi bhedabhyam, this shape and design, material shape and design, don't try to look. Follow my point. What I mean to say, you understand. Mahaprabhu speaking, if there is one a statue, if there is one model of girl, that also very dangerous.
If there is one model of girl, nice, beautiful girl, that is also dangerous. For whom? Those who are not sense organ, not under control. Those who are vijitātmanaha, those having some control, then no problem. And controlling is at the same, like mathematics. And controlling is 100% possible when you are enjoying Sadguru Kipa. And Sadguru Kipa is 100% possible when you are having total bhakti. Chain-wise. So, Mahaprabhu giving this. So, if I speak in front of all preacher, they become very angry with me. I say, for preaching, at least you should get the quality of a Madhyam Adhikari. Madhyam Adhikari, first stage, second stage, third stage. I mean, high class stage. Follow my point. Please excuse me if I have done some mistake. Because due to some speaking guidelines. Actually, for a preacher, he should be at least third degree. First degree, second degree, third degree of Madhyam Adhikari. Excellent. Then he can go for preaching. Siddhanta he can know. He can realize that we should not see any shape and design. We are not going to see, watch who is beautiful, who is handsome, less interested. But anywhere you look, you can find they are made of flesh and blood. Ameddha purne krimikit kaṁ Ameddha purne krimikit sankule sabhava durgandhi vinindhitantare. It's one nice look, Babaji used to say. Ameddha purne krimikit sankule sabhava durgandhi vinindhitantare. Kale vare mutro. Bhule gaya, I forget today due to Ramanti mudha viramanti pandita. Those who are wise, they can realize soul. They never look any girl, any man, no. They are only watching and they can lick your atma. Follow what I say. One realized soul, he can only see atma. He's never watching one beautiful girl, handsome boy, never. Never. Outside shape and design, they're less interested. Follow what I say. So, actually, if some acharya cannot follow the rules and regulations set by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Prabhupada, then there is big problem. Then in that case, you cannot get right information. Follow. Maybe some preacher, why I shout like dog? They misunderstand me. They cannot understand my mood. Why I shout like dog? I know some mistake can be there. So, actually, if you are running here and there, you cannot understand. Maybe some speaker speaking nicely, maybe. But maybe he is not realized soul. Many such things happen. In that case, the question of fall down coming. If you are going outside for preaching, outside world is, you know yourself, what is the condition of dangerous mean? Many brahmachari told me, Maharaj, it is not at all possible to maintain brahmacharya in foreign country. He told me. Gaur Govinda Swami Maharaj is disciple, Srila Swami Goswami Maharaj is disciple. They all told me, Maharaj, it is almost impossible to maintain brahmacharya. Swami Maharaj is, in such condition, it's possible for Swami Maharaj, Prabhupad, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Prabhupad giving kripa. Yes. It's possible for them, but not for ordinary people. So if the rules and regulations set by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, if any acharya not following, then it is very dangerous. Exact, actually, what Prabhupada is speaking is all rules and regulations set by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 100% exact application you can find in the life of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati. Follow what I say. 100%. In the life of Bhakti Purigashi Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Siddhartha Goswami used to say, don't allow them to enter temple, deity room and kitchen. Don't allow. If they qualify, then you can allow. Siddhartha Goswami used to shout, hey, don't allow. Don't allow them now. They think deity room is their playing room. They know how sensitive this asana, so sensitive. If you like to maintain Gauriya Math, you will have to maintain three things very carefully. One is Vyasasana, contamination should not be there. Second is your kitchen room, should not be contaminated. Third, your worshipping room, deity room. If you can maintain protection, very fine protection, then you can run your mat smoothly. Otherwise, in every mat, Koli can enter and kick you. Everybody, you and me, everybody. Koli can get entry. You have to follow exactly what Prabhupada told. Because what Prabhupada, you know, one day, sister of Prabhupada, very senior, almost 60-65 years age, entered the library of Prabhupada without any information. I heard from Guru Maharaj. Guru Maharaj that time Brahmachari, Purnamananda Brahmachari. Prabhupada sighting. Nobody here, nobody here, nobody here. The Guru Maharaj ran into the. So what happens? What happens? Then Guru Maharaj saying, actually very, very senior. Actually, sister of Srila Prabhupada, Bhaktisiddhanta. He never think, she is my sister, this, that, never think that way. This way. Prabhupada never allow anybody. Now at present, no Brahmachari Sannyasi can follow this rule. Can? No, somebody. That's why you are not getting result. Why you are not getting result? Same thing, contamination everywhere. Preaching only possible for at least Madhyam Adhikari high grade. Because Paramahansa not going to preach. Prabhupada Paramahansa, Bhaktivinoda Paramahansa, they preach because they come down to second level, purposely. For preaching, you need to maintain some special quality, which is only possible in second grade, I mean Madhyamadhika. Uttamadhika, not possible. Uttamadhika, not possible. Because you will have to find, you have to speak that don't go there, don't do this, don't do this, you will have to speak this way, na? You have to speak this way. So how possible? Tulsidas ji, that's why speaking, Sadguru mele, Ved batave, Gyan kare upadesh, Kaila ka maila chute, jab aak kare pravesh. Sadguru mean you will have to speak this way. Don't do that, don't do that, don't go there. A Paramahansa can never speak that way. Gaurakishwara Babaji Maharaj, sometime acting as Acharya. Hey, don't go there to hear Harikatha in Navadip. Gaurakishwara Babaji, though Paramahansa, but sometime acting as Acharya. Hey, don't go there, acting as Acharya. So it's not possible for Bhagavanda, Babaji Maharaj, Bhamsidhar Babaji, they're not speaking anything. They never find fault with others. But Gaurakishwara Baba speaking this way to guide us. Follow. Guru means you have to guide. Then what to do? Gaurakishwara Babaji Maharaj speaking. Someday Gaurakishwara Babaji speaking heavily to Bimala Vasa Saraswati. Hey, that devotee going to you. Don't try to give any lesson about Chaitanya 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 Bhagavad. Because he is going to go put plate before Harikatha. Somebody can give donation, he can collect. Don't give any lesson to him. My Prabhu, be careful. Don't teach him anything. This way we find they are acting as acharya. Acharya means you have to give some instruction to me. A paramahansa, not possible. Then what to? This way, paramahansa cannot give you any instruction. So for preacher, they are going for preaching, let them go. But actually preaching is only possible only a high grade madhyamadhikari for them. They can go to foreign country. If there is any problem, they cannot feel any problem. Follow what I say. If anything unusual, they are not feeling any disturbance. Sai Maharaj feeling disturbance? Sai Maharaj feeling any disturbance?
No? Separation from
Vrindavan. Then not feeling any disturbance? Goswami Maharaj, Banagosi Maharaj, Bhakti Bhattisiddhanta Maharaj, they are not feeling any disturbance. That's why, Mahaprabhu, I can discuss this point next day. That's why Mahaprabhu, already knowing that in future they are going to make some disturbance. That's why Mahaprabhu already told, Akarad opi bhedabhyam, srinam vishayinam opi. After all, at least you should realize, Amedya Purne Krimikita Sankule Savava Durgandhi Binindi Dantare Kalevare Mutta Purisha Bhavite Ramanti Mudha Birabanti Pandita. Those who are Pandit, they are less interested about your body, flesh and blood.
Worms and
stone. You should realize this first point. If you cannot realize this point, any amount of philosophy you can memorize, no, it can get no result. First point, you should realize this world is very unstable. It's all relation, nothing. Who is mother, who is father, who is daughter? Follow. At least this kind of minimum, foundation should be there. Detachment. After that, the question of Krishna Bhajan coming. Because Muktukuli Rapasamana, Muktukul Mane, when you are detached from this material world, then and only then it is possible for you to do Hari Bhajan. Otherwise, not possible. Gajendra wanted to get some help from daughter, wife, children. When Gajendra, is fed up, then after that take. Then after that, Bhagavan Hari went there to help, otherwise not. This way you will have to be careful. Preaching everywhere, preaching going on everywhere. But actual preaching means you can change your heart, mold. Not possible. Saimar, you see, those who are taking drug and wine, dancing in field, all girls and boys, Saimar doing Harinam, they are moved. It's only possible. But for everybody, preaching is not possible. That's why so much problem happening, contamination. The only reason, contamination happening. What to do? Anyway, Randavada, Manchakalpada Rosi ke pas, I couldn't explain properly due to hell ground. Very, too much exertion. Trying here, there, I cannot sit in one place. Tumar Gosala ata kholo to, ode dekhao to. Hey, Baba ke? Actually, you are my godbrother. You touch my body, I become sick. It does not do it. My Guru Maharaj never allow anybody. One nice incident. One day, Guru Maharaj doing bhajan in Kalna, morning time. That time, Bardhaman king giving donation that temple. One man used to do service in Calcutta and come back Saturday. So, that time that man coming, Guru Maharaj doing Harinam. Total meditation, doing Harina. And that man coming, calling, Guru Maharaj cannot hear. After that, touching the lotus feet. Guru Maharaj get up. After that, Guru Maharaj then giving some information from Calcutta, what happened, giving all articles. Then Barin Babu, his name was Barin Babu. Barin Babu, what happens? When I touch your lotus feet, I feel some current going on. What happens? I was shocked. Guru Maharaj laughing, all power gone. you took Guru Maharaj's power bank. You see, still speaking this way. So actually, your godbrother Harisauri sometimes embrace me. But when I am outside, but when Harikatha going on, when coming down, going, that time I am maintaining actually my temple, you see, worship. At the time of worship, I don't touch anybody, that's why. Because you are very pure than me, I know. But still, you are going by auto, this, that, touching. So, big problem happened.